bless the Lord, who forgives all our sins. If I say, surely the darkness will cover me, and the light around me turn to night, darkness is not dark to you, O Lord. The night is as bright as the day. Darkness and light to you are both alike. Let us pray. Almighty and most merciful God, kindle within us the fire of love, that by its cleansing flame we may be purged of all our sins and made worthy to worship you in spirit and in truth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please join me as we say together, O gracious light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. Please be seated.
A reading from John. When Jesus saw Mary's profound grief and the moaning and weeping of her companions, he was deeply moved by their pain. Blessed are you with the emotional bandwidth to hear hard things without fixing or minimizing or deflecting. You know the gift of presence. Blessed are you who choose to show up without judgment, with little gifts or small acts of practical help. You know the gift of compassion. Blessed are you too when you are utterly exhausted by other people's problems. And actually, now that we're talking about it, it's getting even more annoying. Your empathy is a precious gift that deserves to be protected too. Today, help me stand ready to hear those divine whispers nudging me to give compassion away naturally, freely. And help me find those who, to my surprise, want to pour back into me, which, fine, you know, I hate receiving. Love given and received without shame or embarrassment, because what else can a big-hearted person do but learn to give and get?
Thank you. reading from Psalms. Hear, O Lord, and answer me, for I am poor and needy. Guard my life, for I am devoted to you. You are my God. Save your servant who trusts in you. It's me again, God. You know the difficulty I'm in and how helpless I feel in the web of circumstances. You, above all, can see all the hidden factors in what is possible in the moment. I need help in real time, now in this present suffering, and step by step as events unfold. Come and be with me right here in this small space where I am stuck. Show me what agency I do have. God, blessed am I with a mind to behold you, revealed in Jesus, ever living, ever one with you, with the world overweighing in his heart. I feel entirely helpless and unable to dictate terms. So, whatever. Can I say that, God? I just need help right now. I need your compassion and love to be active in practical ways, to move into what has been unmovable for so long, to be the change I need, that the world needs. Clear a path, make a way. I need you now.
A reading from Psalms. Many are asking, who will show us any good? O God, this world and its peoples are hurting, and everywhere we look, there is something to lament. And here at home, there are fresh disasters where recovery will be slow, and some things are just gone now, never to be restored. We look for hope that peace could break out, that the hungry could be fed, and those in pain relieved of their suffering, that parents would not fear for their children, nor leaders, their citizens, and on and on. God, when will relief come? When will death be swallowed up forever and all tears be wiped away? When will come that promised time of everlasting joy and all things be made new? Let me sense you with me here in this unfinishable life. I must heap these burdens, my arms are full of them, into your willing hands. Show me how I can be like you in the improbable and creative and even irreverent ways that you staved off the ugliness around you. How you surprised us all with the reality of life. God, somehow let this day be a sign of good things to come.
Please stand as you're able. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful. That your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill. That we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses. That there may be peace to your church and to the whole world. That we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and may not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ. That we may be bound together by your Holy Spirit in the communion of all your saints, entrusting one another and all our life to Christ. O God, by the passion of your blessed Son, you made an instrument of shameful death to be for us the means of life. Grant us so to glory in the cross of Christ, that we may gladly suffer shame and loss for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, creator of the changes of day and night, giving rest to the weary, renewing the strength of those who are spent, bestowing upon us occasions of song in the evening. As you have protected us in the day that is past, so be with us in the coming night. Keep us from every sin, every evil, and every fear. For you are our light and salvation and the strength of our life. To you be glory for endless ages.
Amen.
Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ. Give rest to the weary. Bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for your love's sake. Amen. Your intercessions and thanksgivings are welcome at this time, either silently or aloud. We lift in our prayers this night the city of Baltimore, those who are still missing, those who are grieving, and those who will be troubled for weeks and months to come. Please stand as you're able for the general thanksgiving. We'll pray together. Accept, O Lord, our thanks and praise for all that you have done for us. We thank you for the splendor of the whole creation, for the beauty of this world, for the wonder of life, and for the mystery of love. We thank you for the blessing of family and friends, and for the loving care which surrounds us on every side. We thank you for setting us at tasks which demand our best efforts, and for leading us to accomplishments which satisfy and delight us. We thank you also for those disappointments and failures that lead us to acknowledge our dependence on you alone. Above all, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, for the truth of his word and the example of his life, for his steadfast obedience by which he overcame temptation, for his dying through which he overcame death, and for his rising to life again, in which we are raised to the life of your kingdom. Grant us the gift of your Spirit, that we may know him and make him known, and through him, at all times and in all places, may give thanks to you in all things. The Lord bless you and keep you.
Amen.
The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you.
Amen.
The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.